So today I'm talking about a Honda with the P0137 code, what it is and how you go about fixing it. So what is a Honda P0137 code? Well, it's an oxygen sensor circuit low voltage bank 1 sensor 2. And what does this mean? Well, the onboard computer uses different sensors to know how much oxygen is going into the engine and how much is coming out, and seeing an error with one of the ones that's reading how much has been burnt off and coming out of the engine, and it's seeing an issue with one of these sensors. And bank 1 is always the side of the engine with the number 1 cylinder. And sensor 2 is going to be the downstream oxygen sensor, which is located after the catalytic converter. There can be some different causes for this, so I have to be troubleshooting to know why. And some of the possible causes for it are going to be a bad oxygen sensor. The wiring on the sensor could have an open or a short on it. The harness might not be connected good, and possibly a bad fuse or relay. And there's going to be two oxygen sensors on a single exhaust system. If you have dual exhaust, then there could be four, but on a single exhaust system, there's going to be two. And these are called the upstream and downstream oxygen sensor. So sensor 1 will be the upstream oxygen sensor. It'll be before the catalytic converter. And sensor 2, or the downstream oxygen sensor, will be after the catalytic converter. And the one this code is having an issue with is going to be the second one. It's going to be the one after the catalytic converter. Sometimes they'll be right on the catalytic converter itself, but it's going to be the second one that the onboard computer is seeing an issue with. Most people go ahead and swap out both, but this is the main one that needs to be focused on. And so the first thing to do with this code is go find that second oxygen sensor and check out the wiring really good. Be sure that nothing's come up and underneath the vehicle and ripped apart the wiring, and be sure this harness is plugged in good and everything like this, because bad wiring could cause the same symptoms as a bad sensor. So you're going to want to check out that wiring really good. And one thing to keep in mind is that this wiring is usually on a fuse or a relay, and if that goes bad, then it could cause problems in the wiring too. That'll usually be located up inside the engine compartment. There'll be a fuse box, sometimes underneath the dashboard, but usually inside the engine compartment there's a fuse box in there. Very likely going to be a fuse in there, and possibly a relay that controls this circuit. So just keep that in mind. And so after you check out the wiring, you know that's all good. The next step is either going to be to test or replace this second oxygen sensor. Most people just go and replace them. I'll jump over on Amazon and give you an idea how much they're costing right now. They range around $40, $50. There's one for $79. So they're not hugely expensive. Most people would just go ahead and replace them. They'd replace both of them quite often, but that second one definitely needs to be looked at. So once this second oxygen sensor has been replaced and that wiring's all been checked out, then that's usually going to solve the problem right there. It's going to be one of those things. And so what do you do if you have a Honda with the P0137 code? Well, first thing to do, find that second oxygen sensor. It's going to be the downstream one on the exhaust after the catalytic converter. Once you find it, check out that wiring real good. Be sure that wiring, there's no issues there. There's no open shorts, anything like that. Keep in mind that the wiring's also been on a fuse and sometimes a relay, that if they go bad, then it'll cause the same symptoms as a bad sensor. Like right here, this one that says AF heater, that would be the relay for the second oxygen sensor. They're usually located up inside the engine compartment. If that all looks good, then go ahead and either test or replace that second oxygen sensor. A lot of people would go and swap out both, but this second one definitely needs to be at least tested, if not replaced. And that will usually solve the problem. And so that's basically it. I just wanted to give a real quick, brief overview of how you go about fixing a Honda with the P0137 code. If you have anything to add, please comment down below. If you have any questions, ask me and I'll try to answer them. If this video helps you, please click like, please click subscribe, and have a good day.